going to show you now how we would recommend you to hitch your horse. There's many different ways to do this, but we talked about it here and felt that for the purpose of this video, this is probably the best way for someone that we're instructing how to do this, that is learning and just starting out, the safest way to do it. Now, you know, we can demonstrate other ways to do it that are a little more advanced, but what we recommend when you start out and you hitch your horse, you tie him to the hitching rail. Now, you never want to tie a horse to a gate, but I have this horse tied to a gate. This is a real sturdy gate with a chain around it, and if it were to pull back, you're not going to get in a pickle, all right? But you want to have a nice sturdy hitching rail or a ring on the wall to tie up. But for the sake of this video, we didn't have enough light. It's raining outside, so we tied to the gate. So just because we did it doesn't mean it's right. It's just one of those deals where we want to get the best light for you all to be able to see well. Okay, so what Malin's done, he's put his harness on. He's got his check line hooked loosely. He's got his lines hooked up. We're going to come over here. This is our cart. These are what you would call calves. Okay. These are your hold back straps, right, Malin?
Yes.
You call this your evener, right here. Right, Malin?
Yes, single tree.
Single tree evener. Okay. This is called, we call this a marathon cart, and we really like this cart. It's got brakes on it, which we recommend. We like a cart with brakes. So rather, like some people would bring the horse and back him into the shafts to hitch him up. Some guys will pick the shafts up and walk the horse underneath. Put the shafts over top of them. That's fine, you can do that. But for the purpose of this video, we're gonna recommend you tie your horse, take the cart to the horse, okay? So he's going to insert his shafts into this loop right here, okay? So you got to do this in a certain order. He's going to hook up his trace or his tugs first. And then he's going to hook his hold back to his britching, okay? Now notice how this strap goes over top of this strap, just like that. If you didn't do that, this strap would hang down and sag right here, but this helps hold that trace up. But see, now he's going to adjust this because it's too loose. And so we talked about it this morning where things that were important to include in this video, things that we see people have a lot of error in doing this, is this adjustment between the holdbacks and the traces. Most generally, people don't have that adjusted correctly. And see, like right there, it's too much slop in there. So when the horse stops and goes, it's going to thrust that cart backwards and forwards too much. So this morning we were talking about it, that we felt that there should be about 3 inches of slack between the two. Okay. So now he's going to come over here to the other side. Just do the same procedure over here. So you got 3 holes there, you can adjust that. Thank you.
wrap that will help.
Now, to show you how this is all going to work, okay, this is your trace or your tug that's hooked to your cart, and that's what, when you pull, see how that evens, that's why it's called an evener, see how that goes back and forth as the horse moves, okay. This right here is your hold back and your britching, so when you go down a hill, these shafts push forward, and that pulls against his back end, and that keeps the buggy from coming forward and hitting the horse in the back end, and the horse can hold the load back as he goes down a hill. Up here, these shafts are a little low, I'd say, aren't they, Malin?
Yes.
So he's going to adjust these up a little higher.
You do that, yeah. Loosen this a little bit.
There you go. Okay. You don't want your shafts to extend past the shoulder. So if I come here, see how these shafts are, the ends of them are not exceeding past the shoulder. So right here is about the right length. You don't want it to where when the horse turns, the shafts are poking him in the shoulder. Now you've got all kinds of different variations of this. You've got European type shafts that only come to here. We've got a set like that that we like really well. But this is your standard setup here in length of shafts. So as a rule of thumb, when you're driving, you make sure that shaft does not extend past his shoulders right there. And see how the height of that is where when he goes, when he turns, that's not going to poke him in the shoulder and restrict his movement.